the Computational Justice Lab is conducting research on the criminal justice system, but with data-driven research. And the CGU is really good at specializing in several disciplines, including behavior economics. So I met Greg, the director of the Computational Justice Lab, when I was studying behavior economics, and I found the Computational Justice Lab is really an active lab to conduct research, and I just loved it how I could be involved in all the data analysis. So I ended up studying with him, researching with him. One of the research is about the role of experienced sheriff on the community safety. First, they do policing, so they are functioning the same as police officers, but also they are dealing with civil cases, and they are kind of the chief of the county, and they are the one elected position among law enforcement agencies. And so what I found in my research is that more experienced sheriffs were involved in higher jail crowding, and this can be a problem because if we have a lot of people in jails, that's ruining the welfare of inmates and the workers in facilities, and it's not adding much benefit to the society. I've lived in California for 4 years. I'm from South Korea, and the first thing I've noticed was fairly a lot of homeless people on the street, which I never experienced in my back hometown back in Korea. Since then, I found California an interesting state. First, it's big. 1 out of 9 Americans live here. Second, it got a lot of radical changes in public policy. In criminal justice system, we've had a prison and jail overcrowding issue because of the tough on crime consensus back in 1980s and 1990s. And in recent years, California adopted 2 major policies to handle this issue. The first one is AB 109, which realigned and reallocate prison population into local county jails. And the second one is Proposition 47, which reduced the penalty for non-serious property crimes so that those offenders did not have to be put into the jails. And the main difference between AB 109 and Proposition 47 is Proposition 47 actually decarcerates or let go of those offenders into local communities. So I wanted to know where those offenders go. Where do they go after getting out of the jails? And I looked into homeless population, considering there exists a vicious cycle between offenders and homeless people moving back and forth between streets and facilities. And I indeed find there is an increase in homeless population in the street. Also, I thought government are spending for welfare, such as hospitals and health, will be increased too if it wasn't anticipated beforehand. And I indeed find those spendings were increased. Proposition 47 reduced the penalty of a crime. That means if criminals are aware of that fact, they might be committing more crimes. Within my data, I looked at recidivism rate, which is an offender commits a crime again after getting out of the jail. And what I find is there is no significant impact in recidivism rate, so its endless deterrence effect was not deterred. U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development provides homelessness population information across the United States. So I used that data, and also for recidivism data, I used data within our computation justice lab. Also the government spending data I obtained from US Census too. So they have those state and local government spending data across time, so I obtained it. To be successful in graduate life as a social scientist, I think there are two major components. The first one is technical skills. We do program, we conduct some statistical analysis, so it's important. And the second one, I think it's a little bit more important that we should have some interdisciplinary aspect in our viewpoints, so we can work with practitioners and other people from other disciplines too.